CRISPR gene editing is being tested to treat the painful blood disorder, sickle cell anemia.
Sometimes when like the pain is like really, really bad, it feels like I'm getting bit by like a shark.
The groundbreaking technology of CRISPR. It is actually a gene editing tool, and for the first time in the U.S., this technique is now being used to battle genetic diseases, diseases like sickle cell.
Welcome to UC Berkeley. Question, if you could change the DNA in any living thing, would you do it? Why or why not? My name is Kai, and today we're at the Innovative Genomics Institute to explore the gene editing scientific breakthrough CRISPR. But first, what is CRISPR? Let's check our notebook for answers, and I'll meet you inside the lab.
Research shows CRISPR has the potential to cure any disease caused by genetic mutations in DNA. Today, we'll be taking a deeper look into one disease in particular, sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia is a mutation in DNA that changes round red blood cells into sickled, crescent-shaped blood cells. As the sickled blood cells circulate through the body, they clog blood vessels and cause unbearable pain.
The leading figure of the CRISPR revolution is none other than biochemist Jennifer Doudna.
Hello, future scientists, and welcome to our labs at the Innovative Genomics Institute. My name is Jennifer Doudna, and I'm a biochemist. Biochemistry examines the chemical reactions happening inside living things. Today, you'll see how we edit DNA using CRISPR. Good luck today, and don't forget your lab coat.
CRISPR can edit the mutation in DNA, eliminating the disease. DNA is a molecule found within all cells that stores its genetic code. To fully understand how CRISPR works, you have to remember to edit.
Pay close attention to these four steps in our CRISPR editing process. Now, let's get started.
Do you remember how to edit? It's time to test your knowledge. Scientists usually start the editing process at their desk examining the mutation in the DNA sequence that's causing the problem.
Step number one, examine the problem. Scientists examine the DNA searching for the mutation causing the problem. In this case, we're searching for the mutation in the DNA causing the round red blood cells to change into a sickle shape.
A mutation is a change to the DNA sequence of a gene.
Now that they've examined the mutation, next the scientists will design the CRISPR solution.
Step number two, design your CRISPR solution. Once the problem or mutation is identified and located, scientists design a CRISPR solution. To do this, they design two things, a guide sequence and donor DNA. The guide sequence shows the protein Cas9 where the problem is in the DNA that's causing the sickle mutation of the red blood cells. The donor DNA is the correct version of the DNA containing directions on how to make a healthy, round, red blood cell.
Look around. We are now in the tissue culture room where the real lab work begins. After the CRISPR solution is designed, it's time to insert it directly into the cell.
Step number three, insert CRISPR machinery into cells. For the next step, scientists insert the Cas9 containing the guide sequence and donor DNA that they've designed directly into the cell. The Cas9 acts like scissors when it finds the mutated part of the DNA sequence.
In this example, it cuts the mutated DNA sequence that caused the red blood cells to become sickle. The cell's DNA repair team replaces the sickle mutation with healthy donor DNA. The red blood cells will now be the correct round shape.
Do you hear that popping noise? That's the sound of the cells being electrocuted, allowing the CRISPR solution to be inserted. We've made it to our final step. It's now time to test our CRISPR solution.
This brings us to our last step. Step number 4, test to see if the CRISPR solution worked. Inside the lab, scientists test the cells to see if their attempt to remove the mutation actually worked. In our example, if the tests come back successful, that means the DNA mutation causing the painful disease sickle cell anemia was removed and replaced with healthy DNA.
I have the results from our tests. Congrats, future scientists. The test shows a sickle cell mutation was removed. How did you all do? Fantastic. We eliminated the mutation in the DNA using CRISPR. Thanks, Jennifer, for letting us visit your labs.
You can come back anytime. I hope you've learned why we're so excited about editing DNA to cure diseases. Students like you will be the next generation of scientists. I'm counting on you all to keep our work going and to decide how to use CRISPR to help people and our planet.
Thanks for joining me at UC Berkeley as we explore the gene editing scientific breakthrough CRISPR. So, if you could change the DNA in any living thing, would you do it? If yes, what would you change and why? Be sure to send your notes and visit UC Berkeley online or in person to learn more about how you can get into the field of biochemistry. Thanks for exploring with me, and I'll see you soon.